Go ahead.
Swamiji, you said about completing your responsibilities with us after death also. What I wanted to ask you is, you will be available for us after we leave this physical body.
After you leave the body, wherever you are born, I'll be available. Before that, I'll tell you very clearly, even when you leave the body, I'll be available to you. Be very clear. See, the spiritual umbilical cord, once connected during the initiation, cannot be cut. Only if you abuse the guru, the cord gets disconnected. Other than that, there is no way you can disconnect the cord. Please understand. Only when you say no to guru, saying that, no, I don't want to be any more associated to you, it gets disconnected. The individual will, nobody can deny. That's the ethics of enlightenment. When somebody says no, I cannot help them or interfere in them. Other than abusing the guru, no way that umbilical cord connection can be cut. Whether you drink, womanize, eat non-veg, kill somebody, no karma can disconnect the umbilical cord, spiritual umbilical cord between you and guru.
That is my contribution. Swamiji, will you be able to cut the cord from your end?
No, I also cannot cut the cord. Only you can cut the cord by abusing. Other than that, even I cannot cut the cord. Because in that zone, there is no personal vested interest operating.
Okay.
Understand?
Okay.
There is no personal vested interest operating.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Shall we go to this self-hatred word? You please, go ahead.
Yeah, going back to the cricket question, you know, there is a match between A and B, and one person wants to have a win over A, and you say Tathastu, and then the other person wants to have a win for the B. Who wins?
I will answer this. When we actually complete all this, then you will have a more clear answer. Okay. Otherwise, now this hypothetical question, I can give a hypothetical answer, which will not be useful for you.
Gotcha.
That is
Thank
it.
You.
See now, yes, anything about self-doubt?
Swamiji, I was not very clear about this question. What others think and feel about us, we are not the cause, but we are responsible for it.
We are not the reason, but we are responsible.
Yes. So, Swamiji, can you give an example? I'm not clear on that.
Why don't you give an example?
So many times people come forward and they share, you know, what they feel about me. For example, I can say somebody comes and says, you know, I feel you are such a good leader. But I don't feel it that way inside me. I don't cognize that in me. But they feel it that way about me. So that's what I was asking Swamiji, that I didn't feel I was responsible to create that image. But just now I got a clarity that whatever it is, maybe I may not have said it, but my actions and the way I am behaving or the way I am acting has created that cognition in them. So,
clear?
Thank you.
Next word we will move. Self-hatred. I am defining. Yes. You have to repeat the whole thing now.
Sorry to take the time. Because
No. You don't need to feel sorry about taking time. Your question need to be proper, that's all.
Okay, because you just told about the responsible for others image as well. Can you tell a little bit in a bigger picture? Because in this hall, we can see our own response, our own activities that may project images about us from others. But in a bigger picture, something happened in somewhere else. How can we actually be responsible even
if we
have reasons?
Something happened somewhere else. Which is not in your purview, you don't become responsible.
Okay.
If you put the precise question, I'll give a precise answer.
Okay, so whatever happening out of my limit, which is not, I'm not responsible.
I think even these words, limit, I am not, all this I wanted to answer only after you explain the situation.
No, I don't know how to relate.
Then it's a hypothetical question. Forget about it.
Okay, thank you, Swamiji.
Yes. Let me move to the second word, self-hatred. Yes, please put your question.
Regarding self-doubt, is it like fear is making us to have a self-doubt? For example, I want to be healthy. Fear of losing health, maybe. So will I be able to?
No, no, no. What you are asking is nothing to do with self-doubt. You need little more listening. That's all. Sit and listen. Listen. See, the example I gave, will I become healthy, is self-doubt. I am not worthy of health because for the so many things I have done, it is attacking me, is self-hatred. I am not going to get healthy, self-denial. Now getting it? One good news is all the three can be completed. The best news is we will do it today. Clear? Self-hatred. Listen, when you try to see our whole, all the struggle with the outer world for us, with all the human beings, is nothing but you try to push yourself in some way, but others are not ready to receive you in that way. That's all. How many of you understand? Sometimes you show yourself as a very compassionate person, very passive person in an aggressive way. In a very humble, like this, 120 feet tall cutout. Like this, 120 feet flex. Understand? Please listen. The way you try to push you and the others are not receiving it in the same way, that gap, that pressure which you created, listen, the pressure with which you push you to others, towards others, on others, when they don't take it, that whole thing comes back inside you as a hatred that you are not capable, you are not worthy, I am not worthy, what is this, where am I missing? How many of you understand this word now, self-hatred? How many of you are getting it, please raise your hand. Yes. Getting it? That self-denial. Listen. Let me finish and then self-denial. The other's image means the image you have, you, the others have about you and you have about life, others. You always wanted others to feel great about you, means very trusting, loving, compassionate, caring. But inside you, you think all these fellows are out there to cheat me. Listen, when you open and trust others, you feel vulnerable, you are afraid tomorrow they may cheat you. So you keep yourself closed. But you constantly expect others should open. Listen, the biggest secret is opening up but not being powerless. Trust, open up but never being dependent. Just yesterday I was talking to one of my Swami, I may not be unhappy if you are not here, but I am happy if you are here. But we always think the other person should be unhappy if we are not here. How many of you are getting it? Completely open, trusting, but not powerless. But unfortunately, whenever we are open, we feel we are vulnerable. So we close ourselves, but we expect other person should be open. So this gap, you expect the other person should be feeling you are a trusting, loving, compassionate, but you never trusting, loving, compassionate. This denial, as long as you think this is intelligence, you are gone. Life is destruction. How many of you understand this attitude is what you think very intelligent? I will make others trust me, but I will never trust. Raise your hand. This is intelligent power. How many of you think? Raise your hand. No, you guys are honest. Others, I think you have not heard properly. You have not heard properly. No, that is the truth. Anyhow, when you work, you will understand. Now I will give you the homework, then you will understand. Spend few minutes on self-doubts you have and pen down. Spend few minutes on self-hatred you have and pen down. Spend few minutes on self-denial you have and pen down. After you do this, I'll answer your question. Because then many of your questions might have been answered. If not, I'll answer your questions. Few minutes, yes. Self-denial, you see, you want everyone around you to feel that you are very loving, caring, compassionate person. But inside your heart, you feel all these fellows, none of them are loving, caring, compassionate. I know. They are all out there to cheat me. See, they should feel I am a loving person, but I will believe they are cheats. That is the way power will be in my hand. How many of you are getting it? But I tell you, you can be completely open and not vulnerable, very powerful. I will not lose my bliss. I will not be sad or unhappy, even if none of you are here. But I am so happy all of you are here. Understand? That is why in last my 12 years of public life, I'm moving from place to place, people to people. They all get attached to me. I never get attached to anybody. I go on moving. Because I am happy that you are here. I will not be unhappy if you are not here. Completely being, I trust. But I don't become powerless. Because of that, my trust is pure. I don't have to play the game of all these fellows are cheats. I don't have to have that idea. I don't have to have that idea. Even people who have cheated me, if you have seen me sitting with a close group and strategizing, I'll only say, at that moment that fellow would have been having this mentality. I'll never call that person itself as cheat. I always tell, you might have failed, but you are not a failure. actually this will happen because this will happen only when you achieve completion with you. But this will not be the actual scene before you start your spiritual journey or the completion. All of you are clear? So now can we all spend few minutes on this word self-doubt and pen down whatever you have. One more thing. Don't worry. Don't have doubt whether your self-doubts are right. Even if these three are not watertight compartment that's separated, there will be one or two ideas overlapping on everything. Don't worry about that. Whatever you classify as self-doubt, pen down. You classify as self-hatred, pen down. You classify as self-denial, pen down. And this whole thing is gift of Kalabhairava. Today morning he revealed. So the credit goes to Kalabhairava. And I am 120% sure you will not find this in any book. Because he revealed it. You will only find it in cosmic archives. I know for sure you can't read it.